the camera's gone. Thursday, 26th of July, 2024. Speaker. Oh, my headphones. No, I don't need the headphones.
Called the ATO switchboard line. The ATO is aware of scammers impersonating our organisation. Using the ATO's switchboard numbers 02-6216-1111 and 02-6216-1110, threatening people to pay a fake tax debt or face immediate arrest. If you are calling in relation to a similar call, please phone 1-800-008-540 to report the scam. Scams cannot be reported on this line. This is an ATO switchboard service only. The number to report scams, once again, is 1-800-008-540. Please note, your call may be monitored or recorded for training and quality purposes.
Yes, look, my name is John Wanoa here in Auckland, New Zealand. I've got a reference number here for a case I got in Australia from my company here registered in New Zealand. It's a big case and I've sent an email to you. And the reference number for tip-off is 241.
I don't need the reference number, sorry. I'll transfer your call to the business team. You can give them your reference number. They will find out for you.
Okay, thank you. Yes, look, it's John Wanoa here, director from Auckland, New Zealand company. I've got a reference number for a case there in Australia, and the reference number is 241-096-549-29924.
So is that 29924?
2-9-2-5-4-9-2-9-2-4 reference number. I think it's 724 or 924. I think it's a 924. The writing wasn't too good when I got it back from the email.
It's 2924.
Tip off.
That number's not coming
up, so
what was the number again? 241-096-549-2924. Yeah, it's not actually coming up.
Oh, there should be. It should be, because I've got it written down. Yeah, that's the right number. 991. Pardon?
Have you got a tax file number in Australia?
A what, sorry?
Do you have an Australian tax file number?
No, I'm New Zealand. This company is a New Zealand person. He's registered 303 companies in the company's house office there, and he's got to say where he got $17 trillion from. That's my claim here in New Zealand. He's gone and run off with the money. It's supposed to be a lease of New Zealand country that I put together over 50 years, but he's run off with it and spent it in Australia on 303 registered companies there. And that's what I want to follow up on that. but we might have to check the number on the name of the person in question, because it'll be the biggest white collar crime in the world. And I'm the president of our organization in New Zealand for the claim of that amount of money. I'm the one that's running the whole business here in New Zealand that he's run off with. It's gone to Singapore in the bank there and gone from there to Australia. First of all, it was put together in Edinburgh, Scotland, then back to Singapore, then back to Australia from New Zealand. Originally, I worked with him in the office here. So the money is being spent in Australia now, that amount of money on 303 companies. And that's what I want to follow up on, because it's been 4 days when I reported this. It's gone in your email. You should have an email from me, John Wanoa, in your emails, because I'm... Because he's registered 303 companies in your company's house in Australia with $17 trillion. And that's what I'm investigating here. I've got a tax number here, reference of the tax department here. And I've got a number for you there. If I haven't, I'll need to get another one to replace the one that was sent to me by email. And if you give me your email, I'll send you another one, another request. Because if you haven't got the number, it's got lost somewhere in all the email that I've sent to you. It's on my email, it's there, but you were going to find someone for me to put me onto. I haven't got someone assigned to me yet, because that was the last message on my name there for a case with the number that was given to me. And I'm just waiting for someone to assign the case to. It's a big case, so it's not something that the tax department would have 5.7 trillion tax in it. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The money has been spent. If you go to the company's house, there are 303 new companies with his name all over it, the Mitchell Family Trust, with all the money that paid to make those new companies work. So money has been spent, or I want it audited here in New Zealand, where he lives here and works in the same office as me, and then he's gone through Singapore and got it washed up over there and sent to Australia. So there, it's those companies are on your land with those company names. You see them, they're all registered and active in Australia. You never get 303 companies all in a row in the company's house and pushed all the other companies right off it. There was companies there before, and now there's only the Mitchell Family Trust on 5 pages, one after the other. So there's a red flag there. There's a red flag there. That's your company there.
Okay, so you said it's called Mitchell Family Trust.
Yes, Mitchell Family Trust. Have a look. If you type in the company's ABN lookup, you'll see the Mitchell Family Trust is from Hamilton, New Zealand. That's where that person, Eddie Mitchell, is from there, resident. But he's gone under same accountants, Dun Bradstreet, as my company. I've been in there since 2009 with Dun Bradstreet, and that's his company, and also the New Zealand company as well. The accountant is the same accountant for the government, Eddie Mitchell, and me and my company. The same company that changed to Milton Graham and Ilion in Arizona, and then it's gone into Recover Corp Australia, their company. So I've rang them up, I organized to try and chase that money up, and then I have to go through you there, because it's registered for tax purposes in the company's house office. He has got his name there as the director of 303 companies, just brand new. It's only got registered within a week of all those going at the same time.
So what's the ABN?
ABN lookup. Just type ABN lookup and it'll give you the page where, and type Mitchell Family Trust, and you'll see all those companies I'm talking about. The money don't belong to him, it belongs to me. And the people of New Zealand that I'm there for them. It's not mine, it's them, but it's in my name. The $17 trillion US dollars. I put it together over 50 years, and it's taken a short year to pick it up and run with it. That's all I want to find in Australia. Is it real or is it not? That's a lot of money.
It's real, right?
And you said it's Mitchell, M-I-T-C-H-E-L-L?
Yes, that's correct. Mitchell Family Trust. And you'll see the companies, I've got them all in my email to you. It's in your email with my website as well, with everything, all the evidence where that came from, because that's taken me 50 years to put together. All the history of New Zealand chiefs. I'm the president of the United Tribes Chiefs of Britain and New Zealand partnership, and that's what that is. It's the original native title to New Zealand lease on the land. That's what it amounts to, $17 trillion. That's what the British owe us.
Do you mind if I place you on hold for 5
yes,
minutes?
Yes, that's okay, no problem.
Thank you.
Looking good so far.
My thing is not picking it up, my laptop. I usually pick it up on this, on the desktop. So next time I'll have to go on the desktop to record it, because it doesn't come out loud enough on the laptop. I need to keep a record of my calls. Next time I'll record it on the desktop and leave you fellas on the laptop, so you can talk to me on the laptop, because I need the microphone to pick up her, so I got it on record loud. I have to use the desktop and the microphone, because it picks it up better and talk to you folks on the laptop. I have to record everything. I'll just do it next time. I'll just put your photos on the laptop, so I'm clear on the desktop. It record better.
Thank you for holding.
Okay.
So do you think, like, when you went into the ABN lookup and you put in the Mitchell family trust, do you believe that this one person owns all these companies?
Well, you have to check yourself and do an audit on it there, but I know he's got the trust here, which I was working with in his same office. We shared the same office. So I know with his association with me, we put it together. I'm directly involved with him and his business in real property developer, and I'm the real estate man and bank broker. I'm a bank broker by trade, and also real estate agent as well. So I'm just saying, the only way you're going to find out is to investigate why there are so many trusts in a short space of time, and how come he got the money from somewhere. That's what I'm going to find. If there's money, you would know by investigating at least one company to see where he got the money from. And that's all I wanted to know, because the tax department in New Zealand is also doing an audit. I got their reference number here. I just needed someone that was going to sign to it. That's the last email I got from someone I spoke over there. I didn't get their name, but they just said someone will call me and gave me where to fill out the tip off. I filled out the tip off form and emailed it to your government and where you are there, and I was waiting for a response in 4 days. So I haven't got an email back, so I thought I'd ring to see how it is doing.
Yeah, okay. So we don't get access to, that's a different department and different systems for the tip off.
Yes.
So I'll just pop you on hold for two to 3 minutes.
Okay.
It won't be long.
All right.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'll ring you fellas on the laptop next time, so it picks it up better off the mic on into the recording, and I'll talk to you fellas on the laptop, so it'll come out a bit clearer when I put it right up next to the phone. But I'm hoping it'll pick it up on the laptop, because it's sitting on the couch way away, and I haven't got a mic on the laptop. It's recording on the laptop, but it's not loud enough. The speaker is not loud enough from the phone. I'll just have to hold the phone closer to the laptop when I'm talking to her, so it can pick her voice up on the laptop. I'm just holding the phone just closer to the laptop. I just gotta get her name. It's 6:32, so that's 4:32 in Australia. I just have to see where she's ringing from. That's the Australian Tax Department. It's a switchboard. It's not the person I want to talk to. I'm trying to get through to her criminal division. Got the laptop running at the moment, so we just hope the sound comes out alright. I'll find out what her name is. Just she's a receptionist, not the specialist criminal on proceeds of crime. going to put this straight on Facebook. Yep, that's all right.
Okay, so it actually doesn't give us that we can, you know, see the progress of it or anything. Unfortunately, you're just going to have to wait till they contact you. I do understand your frustration, but there's nowhere for us to even see the progress or see if they've received it or anything. It's an actual specific team and there's no number for them.
Oh, so I've got it going through the Australian Banking Association at the same time of money from bank to bank, so they're looking into it as well. So between you and the news and tax department, then I'm waiting for them to let me know, because I've disclosed everything. I'm a judge in the native court. I do the court jurisdiction over that money and where it belongs to here. It don't belong to Australia government, it belongs to New Zealand government. So it's got to be sorted who it belongs to, that country or this country. And I'm saying I do the British High Court hearings myself as the judge here in New Zealand, legitimate. So I've just got to work in with your government, with our government, to see speedily how it's going to come out. I don't want it to drag on for like everything else drags on, because it just needs to go and check those companies out and satisfy me that we're on the right path. Otherwise, I'm going up the wrong path if they don't tell me it's true or not true, and then we can move on to getting some closure to it, because it's been going on over a year now and no end in sight. And it's 17 trillion real money from Edinburgh, because I do all that as well in Britain. I'm doing the High Court in Britain, and they are partners with our flag of King William III of Orange. So I do all that as well. I put it all together, because now the crypto is gone into the Bank of England, and they've joined from the IMF, and the World Bank has joined with the Bank of England now. So everything financial is changed. You have to go into the crypto where I am now, just working out where our partnership is with Britain, and the Bank of England is still there, but the crypto is coming from America and the federal government. That's all new now, so that you're going to have to catch up with that, because they're making our pensions here non-existent. We have to go to cryptocurrency of New Zealand and no more cash. And that's what's creeping into Australia now. All the banks are shutting. They're going to black out all the banks. All the computers are going to go off any time now in 2 weeks, and everything is a global reset. Everybody, put your computer on, it's all gone. All the stock market in New York, it will disappear, because they're now going to the London Stock Exchange. You know why? Because I know, I do it all the time and follow as a bank broker. I keep up with what our position is with Britain. As partners, we're their partners with the King flag, the Confederation flag, that makes us the partner in all corporations. We're there in all corporations with a king's flag, and that's what I administer jurisdiction over, that and the Admiralty Bank money in the Bank of England. I'm gone alongside Bank of England and not the New Zealand Bank, because they're under your bank in Australia, Victoria. I'm under King William the Fourth flag of corporations here, set here with us. We're the partners with Britain, Derek, in the Treaty of Waitangi, where our two flags are flying. Now, the Governor General has put her flag up and dropped our flag. The flag of New Zealand is now a Japanese flag with a crown on her head. That's the ownership of the land here, and a new flag for New Zealand. It's not the same flag anymore. They've gone and thrown our flag in the rubbish, and I'm putting it up again, saying no, we were here before you. The Dutch got here first, not the Japanese or anybody else. It's our Dutch King William the Fourth, Third of Orange. Yeah, so that's me. I put all the history together to make sure we don't lose sight of Westminster, our partner. That's why I'm all intrigued with the money, the pound note, and us here with no cash anymore. It's gone. No more cash. No more New Zealand dollar. It's now crypto. And Australia is following the same crypto. And the IMF owns the crypto. You know who owns the crypto? The Pope. He's the sovereign of the crypto. And we are the sovereign of King William the Third of Orange. And the Protestant, I'm the Protestant side, and the Catholic Church is the Pope that's on that side of the money. You see, just to let you know, that's what we're facing at the moment. We're all in the same boat, no different. I'm no different to you, and that's what I'm saying. I've studied this all the time to find, we'll make sure we're still loyal to Britain. But Britain ran away to the EU, and it's gone over there. And no, you know who they swear the oath of office in Westminster in Britain? Allah and the Muslims. They've taken over. All the people that in Britain are on the street, and all the Muslims have got the first right of land. Yeah, I know, because that's the way it is. The Muslims run Britain and the Magistrate Court, and puts us at risk of us and Britain. And my white side, or me, is slowly disappearing. Well, fast, I think it's fast disappearing. Just to let you know, I still want to keep our British heritage. But the Pope has changed all of that. Yeah, so it puts us at a loss. When the New World Order and the Pope comes in October, we won't own this place anymore, or anything, because it's a one world order, and you'll own nothing and be happy. That's the narrative there. Whereas us, is we'll own everything and be happy. It's not going to be there if we don't know what we're going to do next. That's what I'm here for, the native people born on the land. Not me and Maoris. It's the people themselves who lose. And you in Australia, unfortunately, too. It doesn't matter who's who. You've got a number now of a crypto number, and that's all they say. That's what you're worth, what's in your wallet. And that's Pope doing that, not the Protestant doing that. It's the Pope doing that. I want to keep our Protestant going, because he's a common law man of the land, and that's slowly fading with the New World Order and what the people are doing in Germany, Frankfurt, Germany. They've sort of gone home and abandoned us in Britain. That's why we've got nothing to hold on to. And that's just being normal, like normal, what we've got to live with. It's, we got to tell our kids, oh, we did our best, we couldn't save it for you. So they'll say, well, you didn't do much for us, because all we see now is buttons with money in front of us. And we've got to play the crypto game, and no more waiting around for you. We're not going to wait around for you. We're just going to play the game of crypto. Yeah, because people have gone in with the trend of crypto on the computer and the mobile phone. That's just me. I'm retired, and me and my friends that are wondering when our government said to us, your pension's going to end, and I say, Where are we going to go? And they said, you need to get into crypto. So I have to go from Protestant, throw it away, and go into the Catholic, when I'm not a Catholic. I'm a Protestant. A native Protestant. So what do? Join the Catholic, because they got the money, and they've got, the Pope has got the birth certificates, which he says he's the sovereign of all sovereign people, because he bought Ancestry.com for $4.7 billion, and because he's got that, he says he owns it, and he owns your sovereign, and that's how he does it. Whereas us, the Protestant, hasn't got much to go on. That's not taking sides, that's just fact. Who made the money? King William Protestant made the money, and the Bank of England Act. He put the Bank of England Act together. He made the Pound Note Act. He did all of that. He got everybody on the land. But now the Protestant is got nothing, because the Catholic took over in England, cleaned the place out, went back to Germany, and left the place bare with debt on hand. We got $400 billion debt in New Zealand. We got to pay it with our wallets. They're not going to pay it in the government of Wellington. They got their own wallets. You see, and the iwi is going to take the land. No more tribes anymore, because it's just numbers and the biggest wallet. And all those ones in the stock exchange is closing in New York. It's going to shut. No more. That's what they said. No more. And they're going to go to the London Exchange, and it'll be run by the exclusive club. Gone full circle. Yeah, just a little story just to let you know. And I'm not upset, but I'm just saying, when it hits, reality hits, then everybody will say, John, you are right. They were planning this for a long time. And all I do is tell my story, tell you, our kids, that's all I could do, tell you what was going to happen, till it happened. Yeah, but I just have to, I don't want to wait for somebody to tell me, because they say, don't call us, we'll call you. That's no good when you're in a situation. When October comes, it's all gone. We're going to lose our country. There will be no more country with us anymore. They're just going to seize everything, mortgage everything. You can't pay the mortgage because there's no money to pay the mortgage, and they'll just take it. That, I know what's going to happen, because I'm a mortgage broker in the bank broker. I know what's going to happen. See, just to let you know that if you didn't know, a lot of people don't know, but they already say it on Facebook, because they advertise it there on Facebook, and I advertise there on Facebook. If you go to my website, it's all over my website, all the quarterings. I'm quarter number 60 at the moment, quartering High Court Britain. I run the High Court Britain. As supposed to be a Maori, but I don't look at it like that. I look at who is running the country, under who, and so we don't have any say, because they're the ones that run the country, and they are salesmen now. The politicians are salesmen, investment salesmen. They're not politicians for us, they're salesmen. They're all selling crypto for $400. If you put $400 in, you'll get back better than what we do on pension. It works. The crypto does work, and so it's the control of it. That's the trouble. The Pope owns it. He owns the crypto as Ripple.
Yeah, okay.
Ripple.
Ripple.
Unfortunately, you just have to wait for them.
Yeah, that's all right. That's all right. You want to do your job.
Yeah,
that's all right.
I don't have any access to them. Sorry.
No,
but,
that's okay. What's your name again?
If it gave you that, my name was Karen.
Karen.
If it gave that receipt number, so then that would more than likely mean they've received your tip-off forms. So
yeah.
They'll look in, investigate further.
Yeah, that's okay.
Okay,
then. That's okay.
Is there anything else I can
No, that was with? All. I wanted some good news, but you told me what I need to hear, that it's in the hands of the department, which is the laundered money and the proceeds of crime. It's in the proceeds of crime. I filled it all out, and they've got my website with all the evidence. I've disclosed everything. There's nothing to tip off, because I told them it's all disclosed on my website and also on Facebook. Everything I'm saying is true until it's not true. So all the evidence is out. There's no need for us to to tip off because I told them. I'm pulling out the tip off because that started the process of investigation. And so we'll just have to wait until they're ready. But I know they'll wait till after October and they'll boot us off the land. That's all I can see. If I wait, they're going to make me wait.
Off the land in New Zealand, $17 trillion
back. Well, I don't know about that because it's on your land and not on where it's supposed to be here. The money's over there spent on those companies. So if you see the company's house there with those 303 new registered companies, there's something really wrong. You can't just go and register 303 companies without money. That sort of money. He's gone down the street and bought up all the high-rise buildings and all the block, the malls, the everything with the money. Because that's what he does over here. He buys all the land and puts up new buildings, new houses, $1.8 million, no less. And so he's a property developer, and he knows how to spend money. He said, John.
And so did he get the cryptocurrency off the Pope?
I don't know about that, but that's where it will lead to, because you can hide lots in the crypto. It is, they made the new Ripple net is the new cash of fiat money. That was the fiat money before, is now called Ripple net. And the ripple is the transfer of money from, or commodities from one country to another, or one person to another. But it's going into the Bank of England just today. They put it in the Bank of England, which has got that crypto in there, owned by the Pope. And so the new crypto money, cash, is added in the fiat money. They put and fiat money as a commodity. So they made the money to back up the money, because the crypto moves faster than the price of gold or anything else. The crypto will shoot up and put the value of the money up, and the fiat money holds up the new Ripple net cash. Just to let you know that that's what they are writing in front of everybody on Facebook. They do all their advertising there to the public. Their intentions of making the Ripple company bigger than Bitcoin or XRP. They use XRP and Bitcoin, and they're going to shut down every other cryptocurrency and put it into Ripple. That's it. Ripple is one world order, one currency, and that's it. But they just use the Bitcoin and the XRP for the little people, and the Ripple for the big people with the millions and billions. Exclusive
right,
club.
So
yep. Yep. That's
they're
how
going to, they told you they're stopping your pension.
Yes.
And you have to go and buy cryptocurrency.
That's right. Yeah, I have to buy the government in New Zealand's crypto, otherwise I won't get my pension. It'll be paid in crypto money, and they haven't quite made the cash yet, but they're saying intention is to pay out with the digital money, the digital Ripple. The Ripple digital money to pay the pension, and then they'll come out with the cash to cash, and they've gone back to Westminster to make the cash. Because under the British Bank of England Act, they don't have crypto. They refuse to have crypto, and they still got their cash in the pound note cash. And now the only thing they changed there was the digital currency made the pound note digital. That's why I'm safer to put my money into the British pound note and not in the crypto, because I'll lose everything. Once you go into the crypto of Pope, you lose it. You lose everything, your property, everything, because their narrative is you'll own nothing and be happy. That's what they tell you,
yeah.
And that's where it's going.
All right,
to.
Well, now that you've put in that tip-off form,
yeah.
So believe has opened up 300 and something companies in Australia and $17 billion.
Yes.
So they'll look into that and they'll get back to you.
Okay, that's all we can do. That's all we can do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yep.
Thank you.
Have a good day.
Thank you for talking to me anyway. Thanks for you in Australia.
You.
Okay, bye.
That's okay. Bye.
Okay, bye. There you go. That's it.
There you go.
Yeah.
You might be on the way, bro.
That's like saying, don't call us, we'll call you. Hang on, I'll just turn my phone. Hang on.
Hey.
I'll just put my
all good?
I'll put my beef rump steak in my pot on the top of the cumulus. So I'll steam it because it'll be nice and soft. I'm going to put it on top of my cumulus. There. Steam away. Yeah, so I'm going to get the bank association on the go. I'm gonna ring them up somehow tomorrow, and that's our memo. We've got to finish off by trying to get in touch with Michael Lawrence and that Bly, the woman Bly. We've got to try and get a hold of them. I'll try and get through LinkedIn communications there and try and get to talk to them on LinkedIn or the media. I'll go through the media because the media will let them know I want to talk to them in the media and make the media talk about it. You see, because they use the media, they don't talk to anybody, they wait for the media to tell them.
Yeah.
You see, they don't want to talk to the public in case they get caught out. Instead, open their mouth, loose lips or slip and get them in the shit. So they leave it to the media to ask the questions so they can edit it out. Things they don't like. They'll take out if it offends them. Fact checkers. That checks the facts and rub the facts out. So anyway, I'll turn this off this laptop. Today is Thursday, 26th of July, 2024. And that was, what's her name again? Oh, anyway, it was the lady, the receptionist.
Karen, was it Karen?
Yeah, something like that. But anyway, she couldn't do much than to wait for those departments to get back to me. It's classed as a tip-off, so they can keep the spoils of $17 trillion for themselves. You see? So I'm going to chase them with the Australian Banking Association. Of that go after bank sender to bank receiver to see where the money went astray. Okay, so that's Eddie Mitchell from Hamilton that's gone into a hiding mode with the Australian and the crypto now creeping in, going to hide somewhere. Okay, see you later. Bye.